Skrever says majority of the Koman in Damara are landless as a result of displacement and relocation. He says for indigenous people, land is important for livelihood than any economic commodity. Skrever explains that development interventions on communal land affect the indigenous society and culture, triggering impoverishment, social isolation, and marginalization among the communities.
There are numerous locations of historical significance in Windhoek that relates to history of these communities. Many prominent cadres that defend these communities during the colonial era are buried at sites that are not declared heritage sites as per yet. The New Independence Museum in Alteveste is infamous concentration camp in Windhoek where Nama and of Herero prisoners were kept during the genocidal war and thereafter. And therefore this motion proposed that the site should be relatively be memorialized and depict the events that transpired in that location.
He says South Africa and Germany played a major role in dislocating these communities from their ancestral land, making ancestral land claim by communities impossible. The LPM councillor called for transitional justice to be implemented by the city of Windhoek as part of the current Namibian administration.
Collective reparations will be essential and will serve tremendously improve the lives of these communities. Land dispossession still trumps post-independence. The city expanded its borders in 2012 without consultation of the inhabitants, leaving them landless. I therefore implore this council to agree to purchase seizable land in consultation of aforementioned ethnic groups to look into the matter of the city of Windhoek farms that are on lease agreements.
Councillor Skrever was speaking during a proposed motion on royalties, land and heritage sites for land dispossessed communities within the city of Windhoek. Selman Vikwa, NBC News, Windhoek.